Networking, security, and Wireshark.
Let's talk 10 ways that companies track you online. Number one, if I'm an end user and I'm connecting to my router to the internet to say Facebook or Twitch or any modern popular website, these are just some examples I put on the board, they are sharing data about you to one another. This may not be direct. This may be through third-party websites and companies known as ad networks, but always, always, always know that these companies are in the business of selling your data to others. You don't know who they're selling it to. You don't know for what purposes. It's all in that little fine print that you sign, but keep that in mind. If you access one site, they can share that information and sell it to many others. Number two, my favorite, cookies. A cookie is a small piece of data that gets installed on your machine when you visit a website. So say, for example, I visit facebook.com. Facebook will actually place this little bit of data, which is known as a cookie, in my machine. This piece of data has information about the fact that I went to Facebook, what I was doing on Facebook, some of the other information about my activities there. And that little piece of data sits there in case I go back to Facebook, but it's also there in case, say, I access Google. Because then Google has a way of coming back and saying, hey, what cookies do you have? And they can gobble up the cookies I have from the websites that I've visited and add them to their own database of information on me. So that's how cookies work. Every time you go to a website, you get a cookie. Those cookies can then be shared with other websites. And then remember, all these websites are sharing data with one another. Number three is your public IP. Now, every connection to the public internet has a unique IP address assigned to it. So this would be the IP address assigned to your home internet connection, like so. So this IP could be XXXX. Now that IP address on the public internet is unique in that it should only be assigned to one user and one user alone. So this IP address can easily be looked up if you go to whatsmyipaddress.com and associates with both your ISP, okay? It associates with your location and associates with your activities. Well, how does it associate with your activity? Well, if I visit Facebook from my home address, Facebook definitely has my IP. It also has my username. And remember, Facebook is selling this information to others on the ad network. So very quickly, if I go to Facebook with my public IP, Google might at some point find out that, hey, I use Facebook and here's the IP. They associate other connections, say another connection to Google, to my identity. Number four, cell phone location services. So if you have a cell phone, right, this is not the home example, this is you're out and about, you're using cellular data, and your cell phone has applications on there that have location services enabled. Well, these applications are able to then send information about your current location back to whatever company it is. Say it's a Twitch application, right? And you're running Twitch, you're streaming from a park. Well, that application could be feeding your GPS data back to Twitch. And then Twitch now understands where exactly you are as you move around your day. And if you don't turn off the setting on these applications, which sends data even when the application is not active, this could be going all the time. So Twitch now has a profile of where you are, where you visit, any given time. But also, remember, it's sharing the data. Number five, ad-supported websites. So an ad-supported website is a website that is not really one of the major tech platforms, but is, say, maybe a video game that you play with your friends. This could be Shell Shockers, for example, because that's a great game. That is supported by ads. So there's ads embedded in the application mobile or on the website if you're using your desktop. Now, those applications make their money primarily from selling information to ad networks in a big way. So they're harvesting your cookies from your device. They're reporting on your tracking information about what you're doing during the game. All that information is being sold up to ad networks and then being distributed through the ad networks to others who want to buy it. So even though that website may not be one of the big tech companies, ad-supported websites, you got to be wary of them because their main revenue source is tracking data. Number six, affiliate programs. So you've probably seen this before. Say, for example, you have a bank that you are a customer of, and they offer you a promotion that if you go to a certain gas station, they're going to give you, let's say, 5 cents off per gallon, okay? 0.05. The reason that they partner together is not because that all of a sudden that this bank has found the money to give the gas station for the extra gas, is that they're both working together to harvest your data. So as part of the fine print, they agree to allowing both the bank and the gas station or the company in question to gather data about your shopping habits, what you're buying at the gas station, how much you're buying, what locations you're visiting. All that gets packaged up into a big hunk of data that gets sold up to the ad network. So if you see these deals, be wary, because it's not just free money. Number 7, it gets worse. This is Wi-Fi and Bluetooth tracking. So this is more of a physical real life scenario. Say this is a big box store, looking from the top down, and here are all the departments, right? If you look at it, there's different aisles with different products and merchandise, and then you have the cash register here, and then you have you walking in here. Well, these stores actually track you as you're walking through the store using your cell phone. So they have these things known as radio receivers or Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. What these are allow you to do is track the user as they're walking through. Anyone who has a cell phone, that cell phone is constantly putting out something known as beacons. Beacons are used to discover Wi-Fi networks and Bluetooth devices. So the beacon also comes with a unique address, usually a hardware address, that is unique to your device. So as that device moves through this store, this company knows exactly where you are in the store at any given time. It knows what displays that you're spending time at. Say this is produce. It says, hey, this person really likes produce. Say this is magazines. And then as you come to the checkout, to the cash register, of course they have another sensor here. And when you enter your credit card number into that machine, it's going to say, hey, this credit card is associated with this device ID. And boom, now they have a profile on who you are, your personal identity, and what device you have. So the next time you go into any one of these stores or stores owned by the same company, say this is a very large big C corporation, they know exactly who you are, what you're shopping, they know how much time you're spending, and exactly where you are in the country. And again, all that's going to the ad network. Number 8, voice assistants. We're talking about Alexa, we're talking about Siri. So these devices, they sit in your home network and they connect to your router, usually via Wi-Fi, and then those connect back to headquarters. Say this is Amazon, they connect back this way, and then they do all sorts of nice, cool functions for you. Now, these devices are constantly listening in your house for the trigger word, usually something like, hey, Alexa, and then they activate, and then they do something. Well, first of all, to listen for that command, it's gotta be listening all the time. And second of all, once you activate it, then it actually legitimately listens and collects whatever you're asking it to do and then sends that back to Amazon. Now, say at the same time, you're having a conversation with your spouse in the background while your son is actually talking to Alexa here, and this is your background conversation, that's also going to get sniffed up by Alexa and sent back to headquarters. Now, these companies have said that this data is not being used for any nefarious purposes. Do you trust them or not? That's up to you. But trust me when I say that these companies, this data is used in all sorts of ways to train their models, to improve, again, ads. And I wouldn't be surprised if this kind of data is also not being sold. Number 9, IoT devices, Internet of Things. These are smart devices that are plug and play. You place them on your network and they do something. So say we have a camera that is positioned at your door and is looking out to detect deliveries. So this camera connects to your router and then back to some kind of internet server. Now, this camera has a record of all your activities, right? Who comes when and where at what times of day. That information is very valuable, and many of these companies sell that information to third parties. If you ever wonder why these devices are so cheap, it's because they're subsidized with this revenue over here. Number 10, last but not least, social media. This may seem obvious, but when you go onto a social media website and you're tweeting and posting and blogging about various topics, and you're doing this publicly with some kind of identification, that information is all being mined. Even if you're not doing it publicly, even if you're using like a pseudonym, like this is me, is like Ant123, and say I'm doing it on a Facebook-based platform. Well, Facebook is analyzing the crap out of all this information. finding out all sorts of things about my identity, my political preferences, my shopping preferences. And that information is getting aggregated at Facebook. It's getting aggregated as well with all my other public activities. So say I'm a Twitch streamer, say I have a Google blog, right? All that stuff is going to be aggregated in some form or another. And then these companies, again, share that data with ad networks to eventually build a big profile about me that's public. So to sum up what we've covered, we know now that these large websites and online companies, they track what sites you visit, they track your cell phone location, where you shop, what you buy, things that are said in the privacy of your own home, what your IoT devices are monitoring, and what your public opinions are. They aggregate this into profiles of you, and those profiles are shared via the ad network to other companies, and who knows who else. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions on the topic we've covered, please join the Discord server where we talk all things network. Until next time.